Being diligent in taking and recording our tires' temperatures when at the track is one of the surest ways to make sure that we're making the maximum use of the tire's available traction. In this video, we're going to describe the proper technique for taking and recording our tires' temperatures and describe what to do with that data once we have it. If you like this video, be sure to click subscribe and comment and like below. We'd love to hear from you. You can follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, and visit callthegrid.com to get everything you need to be successful on track.
Everything that we do with respect to chassis setup is geared to do one thing, extract the maximum available grip from each tire. We can run all kinds of data on our cars to extract this information, view segment times and lap times, and sense what we feel in the driver's seat to tell if we are getting the maximum from each tire at each corner of the car. If you are any kind of a serious track day, autocross or time trials driver or racer, you need to be taking tire temperatures during and after your sessions to establish if each tire is working to its maximum. Tire temperatures tell a story of what is happening at the actual tire contact patch. If you spend money on go-fast parts in the off-season, a good pyrometer is relatively inexpensive and will go a long way in helping you determine if your chassis is properly tuned. Many pyrometers cost less than $200, and a good memory pyrometer like the one from Longacre is just over $400. Visit callthegrid.com to view the affordable pyrometers we offer. The two tunable areas that affect the tire's contact patch is driven primarily by tire pressures and camber. Taking tire temperature yields valuable information into the effectiveness of the tire contact patch. We can learn how the driver is affecting handling, if the car has a tendency for oversteer or understeer, and a static weight distributed evenly. Some rules for taking tire temperatures. Don't take temperatures after the cool down lap. As the name implies, the tires will have cooled down before you can get any useful information. A few laps into your session, after you've developed speed and put some heat in the tires, drive through the hot pit lane and maybe stop near the black flag station. Don't overbrake coming in, as this may yield misleading information. Drive a normal racing line with normal driver inputs. Come to a stop gently, so as not to heat up the front tires too much. If you have someone with you, after you come to a stop, have them take and record the temperatures. If you are your own crew chief, mechanic, and driver, do the best you can to get the temperatures as quickly as possible. You may be able to get the corner worker working pit out of the black flag station to guard your pyrometer notebook for you while you're on track. When taking temperatures, it is best to use a pyrometer with a needle that can penetrate the tire surface. Infrared pyrometers take the temperature quicker, but you only get temperatures at the tire surface, which most likely has cooled down by the time you take your reading. By penetrating the tire surface, you get a more accurate reading. Record temperatures about 1 inch from the inside edge of the tire, the middle of the tire, and 1 inch from the outside edge. You can start from the inside working out or the outside working in, but when you record, do it the same way each time. Be consistent. Start from the same corner of the car each time and work your way around to get all four tires. Again, do it the same way each time. Also, and this is the most critical part of the process, after recording the temperature of all four tires, record the first tire's temperature again. The temperature of the other three tires will have dropped by the time you record the temperature. You can use this information to extrapolate what the temperatures of those tires were when the process started. You also want to capture tire pressures as well. Since tire temperatures will change more than pressure since coming off track, take tire temperatures first, then go back and take tire pressures in the same order that you did the temperatures. Also record tire pressures before you go on track so you can gauge how much pressure build you gained during the session. Also record the ambient temperatures at the track. And if you have an infrared pyrometer, record the track temperature as well. Do this after recording tire temperatures and pressures. Weather conditions change from session to session. Once we have this data, here's how we use it. At each individual tire, the inside temperature should be slightly hotter than the outside, with the middle temperature right in between. If this is not the case, we will diagnose some possible causes for these differences later. Much of our data analysis will come from the average temperature for each tire. To get this, simply add the inner, middle, and outer temperatures, and then divide by 3. The goal is to get the average temperature of all four tires to be about the same. This means all four tires are providing the same amount of work. If one tire is hotter than the others, it is doing too much work. If one tire is cooler than the others, it is not doing enough work. You can also compare front average compared with the rear, left compared with right, and the diagonal average temperatures. You can also see if the temperatures you record are in the optimal range for the tire that you are running. Typical operating range for an R-compound tire is between 180 degrees and 200 degrees Fahrenheit. A street tire will run a bit cooler, and a race tire a bit hotter. You can also use Google to find specific information for your tire. If tire temperatures are too cool, perhaps the driver is not driving the car as hard as he or she can be, or perhaps ambient conditions at the track are not optimal and too cool. If temperatures are above the optimal range for the tire, perhaps ambient conditions are too hot and the driver needs to look to maintain the tires. We now have valuable information and can look to make some adjustments on the chassis to make some corrections. If fronts are hotter than the rear or rear is hotter than fronts, a change in the spring rate or sway bar may help even this out. Stiffen the springs or sway bars at the end that is cooler. If you are happy with spring rates and sway bars, adding or removing front toe may add or remove heat at the front. For road racing, we want a near 50-50 weight distribution, so left and right side should be about equal. Although most tracks do tend to have a few more right-hand turns compared with left or vice versa. Keep this in mind when comparing left versus right side average temperatures. If diagonal temperatures are off, you can look at cross weight to put heat into the cooler diagonal. If one specific tire is hotter or cooler, more or less static weight at that corner may help to get this tire working more equally with the other three tires. Be forewarned, if static weight has changed, you may need to rebalance the car. Looking at the individual tire temperatures, if the inside edge is too hot, there is too much negative camber.
If the outside edge is too hot, there is not enough negative camber.
Looking at the middle of the tire, the middle of the tire's temperature should be right in the middle of the inner and outer temperatures. If it is too hot, then there is too much pressure in the tire. If the middle of the tire is too cool, then there is not enough pressure in the tire. Being diligent in adding taken tire temperatures to your weekend routine, along with taking tire pressures, will provide valuable insight as to whether you are making the most of each tire and helps provide a direction for chassis tuning without any additional expensive equipment. Visit callthegrid.com to see the affordable pyrometers we offer.
If you got something from this video that you can use right now at the track, click subscribe so you won't miss any of our content designed to help you behind the wheel, in the shop, and in the paddock. You can also follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, and visit callthegrid.com where you can get everything you need to be successful on track. As always, peace out, be safe, have fun, and go fast.